invocation of hijama in the body performed by Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If we look, study the book of hijama, there is many, and we go to the websites of hijama, so we see a lot of locations of hijama. But we're going to mention here only the location that was performed by Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So the first location that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam performed is the hijama in the middle of the head. In the middle of the head. The proof of that is the hadith that was narrated by Abdullah ibn Muhayna radiallahu anhu, قال أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم احتجم بلحيه جمل بلحيه جمل من طريق مكة. He said that Rasulullah sallam, he performed hijama in لحيه جمل, which is a location in the way of Mecca. وهو محرم, while he was at the state of ihram, he said في وسط رأسه, in the middle of his head. In the middle of his head. This is the first location that Rasulullah did. Also another hadith talking about location, about that location, he said from the hadith that Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, he said أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم احتجم من شقيقة كانت به وهو محرم. He said that Rasulullah he performed hijama because of shaqiqa. Shaqiqa is it's a part of the hand, a very specific part of the hand that you have pain and stay for a long time. You take Tylenol, Advil, doesn't stop. Yeah, doesn't stop. So the best remedy for it is hijama. The best remedy of it. I myself, I have one of my friend, every 2 months he has to perform hijama. He takes Tylenol, Advil, he does the hijama, and then he stays 2 months and then he does the hijama again. So on. This is his remedy. He takes any medication, doesn't stop. But the only cure for him is the hijama. So this is the action of Rasulullah. And then he said, كانت به وهو محرم. And Rasulullah was in the state of ihram. Number two, the second location. So that's all. By the way, we're going to see later on the picture of those locations, inshallah ta'ala. Because here I'm mentioning the ahadith, and then we're going to go back to the later to the picture, inshallah ta'ala. In both sides of the neck, which is this side, in both sides of the neck, under the ears, just under the ears. This location is called Al-Akhda'ayn. This is a very sensitive area, okay? Someone who doesn't have experience, you shouldn't approach the Arab. So the proof of that is also على الأخدعين والكاهن. So Rasulullah he performed hijama in the أخدعين here and also الكاهن and under the neck at the back here between the two shoulders. He said أنس رضي الله عنه that Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم احتجم في الأخدعين, أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم احتجم في الأخدعين وعلى الكاهن. In this hadith that was narrated that is by Abdullah ibn Abbas also, and then it is Mursal, Hadithun Mursal. So this is the second location. Rasulullah he performed the hijama on the afda'ain and also al-kahin, which is the under the neck between the shoulder at the back. So this is the second location that Rasul performed hijama. Also, another location on the hama, which is the top of the head. Al-hama, the top of the head, this is called al-hama. So, this is on the hama and between the two shoulders. The proof of that is the hadith that was narrated by Thawban عن أبي كبشة الأنماري أنه حدثه, that he told him that النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يحتجم على هامته وبين كتفيه. And then he told him that Rasulullah used to perform hijama on his hama, which is the here at the beginning of the head on top, and then وَعَلَى وَبَيْنَ كَتِفَيْهِ, and between his two shoulders. And then he used to say مِنْ إِهْرَاقِ مِنْهُ هَذِهِ الدِّمَاءِ مَنْ أَهْرَقَ مِنْهُ هَذِهِ الدِّمَاءِ فَلَا يَضُرُّهُ أَنْ لَا يَتَدَاوَى بِشَيْءٍ لِشَيْءٍ. So whoever takes the blood flow this area, which is, so it will not be harming him to use as cure with anything, for anything, which is, that would be enough for him. That would be enough for him for the hijama, which is the third location, على الهامة وبين الكتفين. So the first location at the middle of the hand, the second location in the أخدعين and الكارم, the lower part of the neck between the shoulder, and the third location he did Rasulullah على الهامة, which is the head, the top of the head here, and also between the two shoulder. And mentioned the ahadith about it. Another location Rasulullah he used to do and he did, which is Al-Yafukh. A location called in Arabic Al-Yafukh. What is Al-Yafukh? Al-Yafukh is the location where the bones of the crown, they meet together. When you take a baby newborn, so that part of the head is not full closed. There is a part that is open, still open. It's very soft. So you have to be very careful not to touch the baby there. So that part is called in Arabic Al-Yafukh, which is that location, the meeting of the bones of the head. So the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam that was narrated by Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, he said that Aba Hind hajjama an-Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, someone by the name of Aba Hind hajjama an-Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam fi Yafukh. So Abu Hurairah said that Aba Hind, which is the one who practiced the hijama by the name of Aba Hind, he did the hijama for Rasulullah on Al-Yafukh. And then he said, Ya Bani Bayada, O you Bani Bayada tribe, Ankihu Aba Hindin, Ankihu Aba Hindin wa Ankihu Ilayh. Meaning, like Aba Hind as a reward, to, like he gave Rasulullah advice to people to, if Aba Hind, he asked for marrying one of their daughter, or if he want to give one of his daughters, so that people will be accepting this marriage. And then he said, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in kana fi shay'in mimma tada'un bihi khayrun falhijam. He said, which is the last part of this hadith, he said, after that, if you will be the best, or in things that is the best remedy that you use for medication, so it will be the hijama. The fifth location of the hijama will be that Rasulullah did, it's on the back of his foot, which is the top of his foot here, not at the bottom, which is the top of his foot. The hadith of that, as a proof, is the hadith of Anas radiallahu anhu. He said, أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم احتجم وهو محرم على ظهر قدمه بمنل, which is a location. He said that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam performed hijama while he was at the state of ihram on top of his foot, bimalan, which is a location, min waja'in, and another narration, min wada'in kana bih. What is wada'in? From pain, or wada', which is spring, twisting of the ankle or twisting of the so on. So because of that, and then that pressure on the muscle, it causes blue mark and so on, the blood will be not circulating there. So then Rasulullah he performed hijama because of that. And which is on top of his foot. And then another hadith, which is connected to that hadith, which is another hadith of Jabir ibn Abdullah, قال احتجم رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وهو محرم من وثأ كان بظهره أو بورده. In this hadith, Jabir ibn Abdullah, he said that Rasulullah, he made hijama while he was at the state of ihram from a sprain, was in his back or in his warak. What is the warak? It is this part of the thigh, that's a warak. When we sit on the tawarruk, the last part of the tashahud, so we sit at the sitting of tawarruk. Why we call tawarruk? Because we sit on the wirk, which is the top of the thigh and the back. That's called al-wirk. So he has a sprain there. So scholar explained those two hadith. He said, because of that sprain that Rasulullah has, because he fell down from his mount, so then he did the hijama on top of his foot. And he said, Wallahu a'lam. So this is about the location that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam use and perform hijama on his body. So the after that, there is something which is a general rule about a hijama. And then, doesn't mean that Rasulullah, when he did the hijama on his head, that means we have to do it on his head if we have a pain in our leg. No, of course. So, but Rasulullah, he did on his head for a certain reason. Because of the shaqiqa, he has it. And he did it on his foot because of so-and-so. But there is other location that the people, that the doctor, which is the one who practiced the hijama, they come out. And then he said that the hijama will be used only because of the need of someone that he using it. And then he said, in that Ibn Jarir al-Tabari, he said that the one who do the hijama, he should do the hijama according to his needs. And the one who knows the hijama, the proper way of the hijama, is the one who has experience, not anybody. So then he said, وَقَدْ ذَكَرَ مِنَ الْمُتَقَدِّمِينَ فِي عِلْمِ الْعِلَاجِ بِأَدْوَاءِ الْأَجْسَامِ. He said that the people who has knowledge, the previous people who has knowledge for to cure the body, he said that hijama to akhda'ain. For example, he said that the hijama that is performed in an akhda'ain right here, نَفْعُهَا لِلْعَارِضِ مِنَ الْأَدْوَاءِ فِي الصَّدْرِ وَالرِّئَةِ وَالْكَبِدِ. He said that the benefit of this akhda'ain, when someone does a hijama in here, so it's the all disease that come out because of the blood that comes from the disease that comes from the chest, any disease that is in the chest, also the lungs, and also the liver. So why? Because he said the two veins, they come from those locations. So then if you want to take and cure those part, anything that is in this part, so then use the hijama right here. So according to the specialist of hijama. He said أَنَّهَا تَجْدِبُ الدَّمَ مِنْهَا, because it bring out the blood from those parts, which is the chest, the location of the chest, the lungs, and also the liver. Also he said وَأَنَّ الْحِجَامَةَ عَلَى النُّقْرَةِ الْعَارِضِ مِنَ الْأَدْوَاءِ فِي الْعَيْنَيْنِ وَالْعُنُقِ وَالرَّأْسِ وَالظَّهْرِ. He said that hijama on النُقْرَة. النُقْرَة is apart from here, which is that bones that sometimes some people has it very like a pick here. That's a nukra. And then this is a very sensitive area. One of the scholars, he made a hijama here. Maybe someone who did the hijama for him, he did it for him, and then he lost his memory, as we're gonna mention. He lost his memory right away, and then he couldn't even, he is a big scholar, he couldn't even read Fatiha. People used to correct Fatiha for him, as we're going to see inshallah ta'ala. He said, this type of nukra, this type of hijama, he said it is good for the eyes and the neck, the disease that are in the neck and the head and also the back. And then he said, وَأَنَّ الْحِجَامَةِ عَلَى الْكَاهِ نَفْعُهَا مِنَ الْأَدْوَاءِ الْعَارِضَةِ فِي الْجَسَدِ كُلِّهِ. And the hijama that is performed in al-kahil, between the two shoulders under the neck, the benefit of it is will be gathering all the diseases that are in the body. So this is, Rasulullah did it, so that's very important. So if you want to do hijama, if someone want to do it, so then the first time, so he does this hijama first. And if you do it every 2 months, that will be very beneficial for yourself, for your health. General health. Also, he said, وَأَنَّ الْحِجَامَةُ عَلَى الْهَامَةِ فَوْقَ الْقَحْفِ نَفْعُهَا مِنَ السِّدْرِ وَالْقُرُوحِ الْفَخِذِ وَاحْتِبَاسِ الطَّمَثِ, which is menopause. He said that the hijama on top of the head, which is al-hama here, he said it will be beneficial for the sores, the sores that comes in the thigh. And also the menopause women that suffer from the effect of menopause, so then the hijama on top of the head will be very beneficial to this. This is the saying of Ibn Jarir al-Tabari alayhi rahmatullah. Also Ibn Qayyim, He said, according to that, the hijama, he said, about فَقَدْ تَبَتَ عَنِ النَّبِي صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ أَنَّهُ احْتَجَمَ فِي عِدَّةِ أَمَاكٍ مِنْ قَفَانٍ. He said that Rasul ﷺ, he performed hijama in different location of his head, بِحَسْبِ مَقْتَضَاهُ الْحَالُ بِدَلْ, because of certain situation, different situation. So he has pain here, he does it here and so on. And then وَاحْتَجَمَ فِي غَيْرِ الْقَفَى بِحَسْبِ مَا دَعَتْ إِلَيْهِ حَاجَةٌ. And then he performed the hijama out of the part of his head according to what he needs. And then he said, Ibn al-Qayyim, or the Shaykh, he said, وَالْحَجَّامُ الْخَبِيرُ هُوَ الَّذِي يُحَدِّدُ الْمَوَاطِنُ. That the one who performed hijama, the expert one, he's the one that identify the location of the proper hijama, inshaAllah. So here, this is the general ruling about the hijama.